Wonderful smell on this volume. The musty aroma of knowledge.
What's this? I found something.
So many books in such little time. So many books in such little time. Greetings. I am Cranley Hubert. I assume no further introduction is required. Oh, come now. Surely you've heard of my writing, or my work with the Historical Guild of Arx? No? Ask me a real question, why don't you? The answer is Hubert Oak, of course, my near namesake. A question for you. In what year did Lucian the Divine depart from us? Incorrect! Now perhaps you'd like to return outside and consort with... Such hefty volumes these are. I shall need to finish them all.
I've spotted something. So much death on such a lovely day.
The spirit of a dwarven attendee attempts to discreetly sit.
Get in my way and you'll get an elbow in the eye.
The spirit of an elven dignitary.
Come on, throw it! This bouquet's mine.
Death fog.
A statue of a trumpet-playing dwarf, but something about it smells off. The stone smells of granite and rose water, but beneath the aroma, a familiar smell lingers. Death fog. And then you see it. The horn of the trumpet connects to a pipe. The pipe disappears into the dirt. The scent of death fog comes from under the ground.
First day at work and a void woken attack. Typical.
Over here.
The noble-looking dwarf beckons Ifan come closer. Ifan narrows his eyes, but strides over anyhow.
I've heard tell of you before. You're that Silver Fang or something, right? Look, I know you're him. I know you can take care of problems. And I've got just the problem for you. A very lucrative one. I need you to take care of my father-in-law.
The dwarf winks in an exaggerated fashion, squeezing one eye shut so forcefully it looks like his face just swallowed an eyeball. In return, Ifan raises one eyebrow, slowly.
The man you speak of is not who I am, anymore. And I'll not become him again for the likes of you.
Without another word, Ifan turns on one heel and strides away, leaving the aggrieved dwarf spluttering in his wake. Ifan gives you a sheepish look, all flinty eyes and hunched shoulders.
That's just not the kind of business I'm interested in anymore.
He nods, a faraway look in his eyes.
After the death fog, I truly thought there was no point to anything anymore. But now, after all we've been through together, I've got a new purpose. Stopping divinity.
Crates of Death Fog. How did they get here?
Fasten tight. It's an ambush.
Prepare yourself.
Thank you.
unlocked something. Or locked it. There's enough death fog here to kill everyone in Arx.
A guard rushes in front of you, and before you can flinch, the point of a sharp spear draws a bead of blood from the artery in your neck.
Halt! State your name! Now!
Oh, for goodness sake, woman, lower your spear. That is no way to greet a guest.
Isbeel, I've not known you to be so welcoming to strangers.
Have I yet to disappoint your highness in matters of security?
Your majesty?
Do as she says. Lower your spear.
Yes, of course, my queen. I'm watching you. One misstep and I will have your head.
Your Highness, Bloom of Duna, Flame of the Forge, I present to you the Seed of Divinity.
Queen Justinia sucks in her cheeks, then offers you her unwavering hand. The Queen bids you rise with an upwards flick of her hand.
An audience is granted. I am yet too intrigued to give my leave. Now tell me, Isbeel, why do you allow this woman before me?
My Queen, the human specimen before you is a godwoken, a claimant to the divine throne.
The Queen wrinkles her face and gives Isbeel a sideways glance. Isbeel's red-brown eyes meet her gaze head-on.
Many have laid claim to Lucian's legacy, including his own inferior spawn. I presume our visitor has more than a vague title to boast of.
I am consort to Her Royal Highness Justinia. It is my business to know who serves the Queen's allies and abets her enemies. You do not roam this land unnoticed. Now, let us continue. Goodness, I've met street urchins with more manners. I think you'd have more respect for ceremony. Well, I see no reason to mince words, Godwoken. You're here to die.
Isbeel, whatever's gotten into you? Malodorous it may be, but this is still a court, not a gallows.
Your Majesty, the Godwoken is no ally, but enemy. She would throw your plans in disarray. You have worked so hard. Arcs must fall to the death fog.
I am no monster. Isbeel, what say you?
Justinia turns to Isbeel, looking for answers or comfort, and Isbeel begins to chuckle. Her laugh is low and measured at first, but grows in magnitude until she can barely breathe.
But you're a clever one, aren't you, Godwoken? Fine. I'm tired of pretending I serve this weak wench anyway. But it doesn't matter. You can't stop the death fog. The wheels are in motion.
Isbeel?
Shut your royal maw, Justinia. Arcs will fall and your memory writ. They will believe it was your will, your plan, your command.
For a moment, Isbeel appears almost relaxed. Her eyes flash blue. Her face quivers.
Isbeel?
My queen, forgive me. I...
Isbeel screams in pain and clutches her head. She bobs and sways, muttering indecipherable words under her breath.
Bede Kifamod un Kaegad, Rowem Eke Sifavin et Bukamar Anafking, Goginim Ik Shi.
You blink yourself awake to the cold gaze of a thousand stones and the hot gaze of the dwarf Isbeel, right hand of the queen.
Oh, good. You're awake. At first I figured I'd just kill you. But then I thought, Isbeel, you're wasting an opportunity here. Don't bother thanking me just yet, though. I dare say you'll be begging to die before long. I'll start with lesser toxins, just to see how you react, and take it from there. How strong a dose can a Godwoken handle? How long does it take for one to succumb?
Your lips open, but no words spill forth. You try to lift your head, but it is no match for gravity. She has paralyzed you. Only your eyes are free to move.
Don't fight it. You'll only make things worse. Oh, but I've been so rude. You should know the real me. Oh, it's good to give myself a rest. Those masks can be darned pesky.
Every ounce of energy within you evaporates. You have no more control over your own source than you do of your flaccid body. Isbeel shakes her head at you. Tut, tut.
Do try to relax. The harder you fight, the harder the experiment will be on you. Ah, that dose proves quite alarming for my normal subject. Let's try a new approach, shall we?
The attempt is futile. Every inch of your body is useless, though your senses still register every sight, sound, and smell.
Let's see now. I have just the thing. Just a spritz, mind you.
You struggle to move, and you feel your toes wiggle, and your fingers twitch. The paralysis is waning.
Interesting. Some of the results are quite unexpected. Now, let's move on to death fog. Live or die, you've already proven most... Well, I was going to say useful, but perhaps entertaining is the better word.
Isbel turns the valve, but no fog wafts forth. In that moment, you feel your bones and muscles awaken. You've regained control of your body at last.
What's wrong with it? Guard! Come! The guard worker's broken free of my spell!
I've got to get out of this death trap.
Prepare yourself. yield on none. Glory is mine. I'm ready.
yourself.
great machine sits before you. Pipework, tentacles outwards and upwards, the conduits piercing the ground overhead, wending their way towards the city and her people above. Even through the seals of the great cistern, you scent the acrid sting of the death fog inside.
Do you think Arx is safe in my death? I faced the grave before, you know. Yet through the God King, I have eternal life. You've such a soft spot for that woman. Do you really think she didn't know exactly what releasing death fog into Arx would mean? Don't be fooled. I may have planted the seed, but she gleefully tended to it. My entourage is taking good care of her, I promise. Well, the Master's purpose is his own to speak, not mine. You're good with words, so sincere. I almost believed you. But let's pretend I fell for your little persuasion game. I'll tell you the Black Ring's plans on one condition. You release the death fog. You bring my mission to an end. Then our little chat is done. And to think I called you persuasive. I think Arx is safe in my death. I faced the grave before, you know. Yet through the God King.
No. It must be the God King to claim me. How is it you?
I've spotted something.
think Arx is safe in my death?
No, it must be.
I've spotted something. What's this? I found something.
What's this? I found something. That sounds like the Queen. What's this? I found something.
By whose hand? Yours? It should have been my own axe to slice her neck. Take me to her bones. I've a mind to chop them into pieces, the foul witch!
Justinia struggles to control her rage. She closes her eyes. She breathes the sewer's fetid air. She waits.
She is dead. And that is that. She was a scientist of sorts, or so the town criers chanted. She knew of the ways of nature and beyond, and I invited her to court to show me. She healed the sick and soothed the wounded. I saw it with my own eyes. I brought her close. Her words were wise, and her aims, well, they seemed so pure. It was after Alexander assembled the quorum that Isbeel turned my mind to thoughts of war. Our scouts and spies aided dwarven sorcerers where and when they could, but Isbeel insisted the monks and shriekers would touch dwarven land. When we came to Arx to prepare, she rarely left my side except to tend to her laboratory. I'd no idea what atrocities she'd been committing there. Lady Kem is known to harbor those in need from foreign lands. I will be safe at our estate. Then we part. Mayhaps we shall meet again. Farewell, Godwoken.
Shall Lord Kim be joining us, my lady?
Linda, I fear, is far too busy with his little coup. Perhaps he may find some time for us later. But let's not hold our breath, shall we? More tea. Do pass the tea.
Ah, you're looking
well. Well, hello again. Do be careful not to break anything, my good lady.
Dreadfully crowded these rooms have become. One so yearns for the calm of earlier days.
Have you managed to rummage up any turnips?
Look out! I see a trap nearby.
Huh.